Hello plant friends, Adina here from Plants Equals Happiness. Today I was thinking to do a video about two Hoyas that I love and care, and to show you other houseplants that I acquired last week, and something fun and creative, which when I was a child I used to do all sorts of wood burning shapes, like flowers, or I don't know, a picture or something like that. So let's just start it. So the first Hoya that I'm going to talk about, it's Hoya Nummularoides. Hoya Nummularoides, it's native to Asia and Thailand. It's a beautiful plant with intensing features. It has verdant green leaves, and despite their robust appearance, they are very fuzzy to touch. Unlike some other plants, it does not require direct sunlight, daily watering or repotting every few months. As you can see, the leaves, they are very pubescent. And fuzzy when you touch them. That's why I really love this type of Hoya. It's a beautiful Hoya to have in your collection. Very nice. Absolutely gorgeous. Keep the temperature between 65 to 90 degrees Fahrenheit or 18 to 32 degrees Celsius. The flowers have shape like little white stars with vermilion center. Due to the flowers, it is among the most richly scented Hoya family members. Hoya Nummularoides is a fast-growing plant. There are epiphytes species that comes from rich jungles. They usually blossom twice a year, in fall and in spring. If you want to fertilize, make sure that your fertilizer is rich in free elements, nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium. As you can see, the soil, it's a very airy soil, and it's rich in perlite. I will show you the flowers, which they are absolutely beautiful. Absolutely beautiful flowers. And this Hoya Nummularoides, it's a very easy Hoya to grow in your care. Doesn't really require that much. I love the back of the leaves as well. As you can see, they can get sun stress. Absolutely gorgeous Hoya. The second one, which I'm sure everybody loves this one as well. This is Hoya DS70 or Hoya Species Affinity Burtoniae. Originally comes from Philippines. The leaves are pubescent and have olive green foliage. Hoya Species Affinity Burtoniae can have a reddish cast to the leaves in higher light and a dark ring around the edges of each leaf. Hoya Species Affinity Burtoniae has dark pink to reddish flowers with a yellow center. Look how beautiful they are. Absolutely gorgeous Hoya. And as you can see, the pot is absolutely gorgeous. It's a face planter, which I really love. And of course, this Hoya is growing so nicely for me. I will show you the new growth. Look how beautiful it is. I love this Hoya. It's a very easy Hoya to grow. Beautiful Hoya. I will show you the flowers. The flowers, they are so beautiful. Look how beautiful they are. Absolutely gorgeous. Gorgeous flowers. Very unusual. So this is DS70 Hoya species affinity Burtoniae. I will show you my small hole as well. So the first one, as you can see, it's a beautiful cactus, and this cactus is Notocactus Hasselbergii, choice white spine cactus from Brazil, long-lasting red flowers in summer. As you can see, it's already flowering. You can see in the center of this cactus there are flowers, and I can't wait for the buds to open up. Beautiful, beautiful cactus. The second one, which is really, really beautiful. I love, 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 love this cactus. The name of this cactus is Corypanta verdeminae. They say choice cactus from Mexico. Large yellow flowers in summer. This one doesn't have buds yet, but I hope it's going to develop very soon. Love, 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 love this cactus. And the third one, which you can see, is in a terracotta pot. This is a Tridescantia. I absolutely love, 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 love this houseplant. They say Tridescantia. Doesn't really say what kind of type, but I love the stripy leaves, as you can see how beautiful they are. Absolutely gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous houseplant. And I love the way it grows as well. Really, really nice. Beautiful, beautiful houseplant. And on the creative side, I bought a wood burning kit, and I really, really, really love. As you can see, it comes with so many wood burning heads that you can use. And of course, with two templates, with the ABC and 1, 2, 3 and etc. And what I did, look how beautiful it is. And of course, you can stick this heart in any pot you like. You can stick here. Absolutely gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. Or you can stick here on my very fussy plant, which is a Calathea white fusion. I have this Calathea for quite some time now, and to be honest with you, you can see the way the leaves are just drying out. And I don't know why, to be honest with you, because I keep the watering on schedule, and I use rainwater as well. And you look at this leaf, it's absolutely beautiful. You see, it doesn't have any problems whatsoever. But look at these ones. You see, they starting, of course, I will give you an example of this one. It started to get dry. And this one as well, you can see, it started to get dry. Not only on the edge, but at the beginning of the leaf as well. And it's really, really frustrates me so much, because I love this Calathea white fusion. And they are not very cheap to buy them, you see. I don't know what's going on. And to be honest with you, this one, it was watered quite recently. I didn't really look, but I cannot see any roots popping out from the pot. So I think it's not root bound. If you have any tips, please, can you comment below and tell me what kind of treatment I have to give to this Calathea weight fusion. I don't know, to be honest with you. It's a very difficult plant. So that's it for today. On the creative side, you can see the hearts, that they are from wood, and I cut them from a piece of a ply. And of course I use my wood burning kit, which is not really that expensive. I bought it from Amazon. And you can do so much with this wood burning kit. Absolutely love it. Love it, love it.